Hello, Sagittarius. This is Carrie from Celestial Forecasts with your love reading focused on the second half of June from the 16th all the way through the 30th. General advice as always. So if this is your first time tuning in, and for my regular subscribers, take from it as always what makes sense for you personally. Release the rest. So let's begin with these two decks. This is the Pink Divine Love Oracle by Jennifer Aquarius Tarot. And we'll grab some cards from the Relationship Design cards by Sister Moon Tarot. I'll clarify with my own tarot decks. This is part one of the reading. If it resonates with you, the messages make sense, definitely stick around to the end of the video. There will be a preview to the extended reading. And if it happens to make sense for you, you're more than welcome to tune in on my Patreon page for the second half, the extended reading. That link is down below in the description box. All right, guys, so let's get into it. Let's take a look and see what it is that you need to know entering into the second half of June. Angels and spirit guides, please, for Sagittarius. Right, guys, so here we go. What do you need to know? What do you need to be made aware of? So we are starting things off with a message, texts, phone calls, conversations. If you have been waiting to hear from somebody, you may very well get some form of communication, maybe the second half of the month. Okay? You could also be sending a message to someone who is wanting to reach out, or you wanting to reach out to somebody. Okay, now this is interesting, this next message. Off the hook. Do you see that? Ignoring you on purpose. So if this makes sense for you, maybe you have been trying to reach out to somebody. They're not returning your call or your text. They have basically been ignoring those messages. And for whatever reason, we'll get into it with tarot and the other messages to see what's going on there. Look at the next card, guys. We've got sheltered off, trust issues and insecurities. So if this is something that you are resonating with right off the bat, Sagittarius, there were trust issues, or there still are. They could be feeling very insecure at this point, which is why they're ignoring you and not returning your messages, or it could be the other way around. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab some tarot and see what's happening here. So take it from whichever perspective makes most sense for you. So if you're the one that's been reaching out, you're not hearing from them, this is what's going on. Maybe they don't trust you. They're feeling very insecure. They've got their own issues. They might have blocked you. Okay, it could be that. Or again, it could be the other way around. Okay, so let's grab some tarot. I'll be pulling, if I didn't say it already, from my Valentine Connection tarot here. So what's going on, Sagittarius? We do have the Six of Wands, so this is about recognition. It is actually a very positive energy, a victorious energy, successful. And so I'm ultimately feeling that there's somebody here that might have recognized something about the connection that they didn't recognize before when you guys were together. And this could also be telling you that if you guys were to finally let your guard down and get the conversation rolling once again, maybe there is the potential that you guys can still work this out. And look at the next card here. We've got the Three of Pentacles. So these two cards together, it's all about the two of you working together and collaborating, working as a team. And if you guys were to do that, get onto the same page, it has the potential to be successful once again. So we do have the Eight of Wands. This represents this very quick energy, fast movement, as we can see here. So maybe this is you, Sagittarius. You're wanting to get things moving already, especially if there has been no communication, and maybe that's frustrating you. We also have the Six of Cups. So this is tapped into those happy memories that you guys have shared. This is past energies right here. So you could be feeling very nostalgic about someone from your past that you have gone into separation with, because this right here is a desire to come back into union. Now, this is interesting as well. We've got the Page of Wands. The Page of Wands represents good news, cheerful news. It could be that you've got good news that you want to share with somebody, and it could really uplift them, make them happy. But if they have blocked you, if they're ignoring your calls, your texts, they don't want to talk, then there's some sort of blockage going on here. And here's the blockage right here. The Seven of Wands. They could be protecting their heart space right now. They could be keeping their space, keeping their distance. As we can see here, you know, they're not taking your calls. They're not returning communication, ignoring your text, your phone calls, any sort of interaction. So we'll have to dig a little bit deeper as to what's going on there. And we also have the moon. So the moon is an illusion. The moon can be tapped into deception and secrets and lies. It could have been an affair. That could be why you guys are not talking, because somebody created a situation here. If not you, then it's the other person, Sagittarius, where we have this going on, trust issues and insecurities. So that makes sense why that's presenting itself in that way. Let's go ahead and grab some additional advice from the relationship design cards here for Sagittarius, second half of June. What else do we need to know here? Somebody's being triggered. Maybe you are, Sagittarius. Shadow, rejection, abandonment. You know, the other person could also have experienced abandonment issues, or they are afraid that you would reject them if they were to reach out, or you're afraid of rejection. If they've blocked you, if they're not speaking to you, or they're ignoring you. Clearly, there is an imbalance here. That's the next card. Rocky, unstable, and faulty. And that's something that you guys have to work through. And then this card is flying right out. Look at this, guys. There was something challenging here. A betrayal. Dishonest, disloyal, broken. That's making sense for me. And that's why, you know, going back to the Seven of Wands, as well as the moon's energy, you know, that deception, that's why this is going on here, you know, and more than likely why you guys are not speaking, why you're not talking. So they could still feel very triggered by something challenging that has happened here between the two of you. You could find, Sagittarius, if it's reversed for your situation, that you're not ready to talk because they were dishonest with you. They betrayed you somehow. They betrayed the trust. All right, so let's go ahead and clarify that with some tarot. I'll pull from my Celestial Cosmos tarot deck here. Angels and spirit guides, please, for Sagittarius. Second half of June. We do have the Ten of Pentacles. We also have the Knight of Wands. We've got the Ten of Cups. So tens here representing some sort of cycle that is completing here. So I'm still ultimately feeling, even though things are not in a good place between you and this person, they still feel drawn to you. You still feel drawn to them. There is the potential that you guys can still have this Ten of Cups where things can really balance itself out. It does represent harmony in the relationship, divine love. It's a beautiful card. It's a beautiful energy, fulfillment, manifestation of all of your dreams when it comes to the relationship. You can still have all of these things. I have a feeling part of the challenge and why there's such an imbalance and such an unstable foundation here could be, and I'm just picking it up on behalf of a masculine energy because of the Knight of Wands, not wanting to either settle down, or they might have gotten themselves mixed up in drama, because we do have trust issues that are surfacing. And so that affected not only the relationship, but it affected a family if you guys already had children together. So even though at one point in time that foundation wasn't strong, it can be made to be a much more solid foundation here, as we can see here. Money matters, looks, pretty good. So that could be an area of your life that is improving, Sagittarius. Look at the next card here, guys. We've got the Sun. You see these two cards, actually these three cards right here, are very positive in energy. And I just ultimately feel there was a situation where one partner just either wasn't ready for commitment or they strayed, basically. This happiness can be restored, but it ultimately falls on two people to be able to make this work, because you can't do it all on your own. And that's why it's so crucial, going back to the cards that came through already, for you guys to work together, work as a team, collaborate, right? So things can still fall into place, but we clearly see that this was a part of the equation. Deception and betrayal. You see how it's right next to each other? Dishonest, disloyal, broken, betrayal, and then we've got the Seven of Swords basically representing the same thing. All right, Sag. So I'll leave part one here. If it resonates with you, as I've mentioned, stick around. The extended is coming right up, the preview. And if you want to watch the whole thing, you know, that's available on Patreon. That link is down below, as I've mentioned. And if you want your own personal private reading, that info is down below as well. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you next time. Take care. Picking up off of the same type of energy as the Knight of Wands that came through on the first half of the reading. You know, yes, they could be very charming, but this is someone who is not looking for commitment. And that's the vibe that I pick up from there. And then we have healing family issues. You know, we did get the reference to the Ten of Cups, and that picks up off of a family dynamic. It picks up off of a happy relationship where everything can still ultimately work itself out. But if you guys are not working together, then the relationship will suffer as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab some tarot to see what else is going on here. I'll be pulling from my tarot teacher, the revised edition. So maybe you all have already detached from somebody who betrayed your trust. And the unrequited love card, it does say there's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. So these two right here for me as well. Let's just say either a spouse, a girlfriend, or a boyfriend cheated on you. Let's say that's what's going on. So they might have realized the person that they moved on to or were with, could have been the third party. They realized, you know what? It's not what I was looking for. It's not what I was hoping for. Maybe they realized that there wasn't enough attraction or chemistry through that third party situation, through all of that drama. And so maybe they've also decided to free themselves from that in order to restore the committed relationship that you guys are in. So I kind of get that for some of you. Take it if you want.